Welcome back, guys, to another daily news video where I bring you the best news in the past 24 hours that happened in crypto community. Hopefully, I will bring you these kind of videos every single day at the same time, and this is currently the second day of these kind of videos. So today we have three interesting news that happened, and the first one has to do with Facebook. So Facebook is going to start exploring how they can implement blockchain into their own products. And they are already starting with David Marcus starting to find the ways how they can implement blockchain in Facebook. So David Marcus was lead in Facebook Messenger app for a few years, and now he's switching with a small team to explore blockchain. So he's going to start with a small team now, and they are saying that this is their first exploration of blockchain technology, which I don't actually believe to be true, because when they had so many ads for cryptocurrencies, and when they made so much money from cryptocurrency ads, and they have seen so many coins skyrocket in price last year, and especially because Mark Zuckerberg, the CEO of Facebook, has so much relationship with the Winklevoss twins, which have about 100,000 bitcoins, I don't think that this is their first exploration of Bitcoin and of the blockchain technology. I think they have been working on it for a few years now, maybe not in such a big way, but they have been exploring it for sure, because such a big tech company doesn't just say, yeah, we are going to explore it now and we are going to start testing the technology which has been active for 10 years. They have probably been doing it for a few years now, and maybe not in a big way, but they have certainly been exploring it. So it will be interesting to see what this new technology can bring to Facebook and how they can implement this technology. And hopefully it will change the way that they protect the user data, because they have been known to sell the user data and to have leaks of user data. And hopefully if they can put all of our personal information on the blockchain, maybe they can protect it a little bit better and make us all feel a little bit more secure about using Facebook. So the next news is about mining. As you probably all know, Bitmain released the new Z9 miniminer, which is used for Equihash mining. So the coin that they are targeting is Zcash. Zcash is the biggest Equihash coin, and it will bring them the most profits. And Bitmain is known to be mining with those ASICs, which they decide to sell for a few months before they release them. Maybe they've been mining with them for like 6 months or even up to a year. Nobody knows that, but you know that when you buy those miners, they are already used, and people have even found dust and spider webs inside of those miners. So they have been used for a long, long time, and it's not like they just made them, test them for like a week and then decide to sell them, because there would not be so much dust inside of them. So the Zcash Foundation said that they will make it the highest and the top priority to fork the Zcash coin with a new algorithm. So this new algorithm should be ASIC resistant for at least some time, and if they don't want to use some kind of algorithm that already exists, maybe like Lyra 2 Revision 2, they will have to make their own algorithm. Maybe they will just make a new one, and or maybe they will just use some algorithm that already exists. Nobody yet knows, and it has not been decided, but I really don't understand why they don't have those algorithms already ready and already developed when those kind of things happen. Because as you have seen with Monero hard fork in about 2 weeks from when the ASICs for Monero were announced. So it is possible to make forks so fast and with enough quality standards that nothing bad can happen to the coin. And they already said that they will have semi-annual forks of the Monero coin to fight ASICs, even if they are trying to be developed and they have already not been developed for the new algorithm that they choose. So the Zcash Foundation should have this top priority for some time already now, and not just starting to have it top priority now, because what's the point of having it change algorithm once those miners have been mining for maybe a year on this kind of algorithm? They are destroying the decentralization, and they are destroying the mining profits for our small miners. So I hopefully they will change the algorithm pretty fast, because if it will take them a few months to do it, then those ASICs will just grab a little bigger piece of our cake. And the last news today that we have is with Voltor Exchange. Now, this is not really popular exchange, and I have actually never heard of that exchange before. I only use Bittrex, KuCoin, and Coinbase. So I'm not well educated about this Voltor Exchange, but they are the first exchange in the world which implemented a Lightning Network for its transactions. And right now, Lightning Network is growing almost every single day, and the number of nodes and number of Lightning Network channels is increasing. So that means that the main Bitcoin network will not get so congested with all of those transactions, and hopefully a big part of those transactions will be happening on the Lightning Network. And we have seen how long does it take for exchanges just to implement SegWit, so it will probably take them a lot longer to implement Lightning Network, and especially because Lightning Network is such a new thing that happened to Bitcoin and that is happening to other cryptocurrencies, that we are still not 100% sure how safe that is. It will take maybe like a year or two for people to get trust in that, and especially because it needed such a long time just for SegWit adoption to go up, and currently it is at about 35%, so still majority of the people don't even use SegWit, so it will take a long time for a Lightning Network to be implemented in big exchanges. Over here you can see the Lightning Network stats. So currently there is 1684 Lightning nodes with 15,000 Lightning channels, and the SegWit in the last block was only 20% of the transactions, and it goes up to about 30%. So SegWit is about 20-30% of all transactions on the Bitcoin network, but it really depends on the day and on the block. Sometimes it is as low as 14%, and sometimes it goes to like 40%. So we are still a long way to go from everybody using SegWit and from everybody using Lightning Network, which should be a lot better than having every single transaction on the main chain, especially because Bitcoin can only do 7 transactions per second, which is really, really low, and some coins can do a few thousand of those transactions. With the highest number of transactions, which should be happening on the high performance blockchain, which should have about 1 million transactions per second. So Bitcoin has a long way to go from having a few thousand transactions per second, which is really needed on such a huge coin, but the technology is there and it can be implemented. It just will take a lot of time. So thank you guys for watching this video. Let me know what you think about it. Maybe you have some recommendation how I can improve it. Leave it down in the comment section, and see you soon in another one. Bye.